Hi everyone, this is Paul from Newzik, and in this video I will present you the new features available in the latest version of your favorite sheet music app, Newzik 5.6, which we just released on the App Store. We constantly work to improve Newzik and make it even more enjoyable for you based on the feedback you give us, so I hope you will like this new version. To enjoy these cool new features, visit our App Store page and update your app, the link is in the description. The main changes we introduced in Newzik 5.6 concern the annotation mode and the overall annotation experience. First off, we introduced a direct annotation mode. We've received countless requests for this change over the past months, so I'm very happy to tell you that it's finally here. In previous versions of the app, even if you used an Apple Pencil, you needed to make a first tap on the screen to enter annotation mode and start marking up your music. This unnecessary tap resulted in a loss of time and it was pretty frustrating. With Newzik 5.6, you don't have to do this anymore. Just start writing with your pencil and the app automatically goes into annotation mode, which makes the experience a lot more intuitive and natural. Also, turning pages in annotation mode used to be pretty confusing because you couldn't use your fingers like you would normally do. Instead, you needed to use the two tiny arrows on the bar, which was a bit cumbersome. To solve this issue, we now detect if you have a Bluetooth pencil connected to your device, and if you do, you can turn pages by tapping or swiping on the sides of the screen with your fingers, exactly like you would do outside of annotation mode. Finally, we realized many of you weren't aware that the annotation bar could be moved on the screen so that you could annotate your music underneath it. We used to have little handles on each side of the bar to do this, but this mechanism wasn't very obvious for a lot of you. So now you can just flick the bar with your finger to quickly push it to the top or the bottom of the screen more easily. You don't need to grab any specific part of the bar to do this, you can do this anywhere, and hopefully this will make moving the bar on the screen more straightforward. We hope these changes will make marking up your parts with Newzik more enjoyable and natural. Please let us know if this is the case, and if you have any additional suggestions for us on this topic, you can always let us know by email at contact@newzik.com or on Facebook as well as Instagram. All the links are in the description. But that's not all we introduced with this new version. We also worked on the ways you could export your music from the app. Before this new version, when you wanted to export a complete setlist or project, we generated a unique PDF file for all the pieces in this setlist or project. This was pretty convenient in some contexts, but it could be frustrating in others. Especially if your intent was to back up your files on a hard drive, for instance. So while it's still possible to export several pieces to a single PDF, you can now choose to export to a zip file that contains individual PDFs for each piece in your setlist or project. Hopefully this will make Newzik even more flexible for you. That's it for Newzik 5.6. I strongly encourage you to go to the App Store to update your app right away if you haven't already. The link is in the description of the video. If you're not a musician yet, you're totally missing out on a technology that will make working with sheet music more straightforward, practical, and more enjoyable for you. Visit our website newzik.com for more information, or just take my word for it and download the app for free from the App Store to try it out and see for yourself. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button to stay up to date with our latest releases, tutorials, and interviews. You can also follow us on Instagram and on Facebook, the links are in the description, and I will see you again in an upcoming video. Bye!